How's it going, everybody? Doing quick garage sales pickup from Friday and Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I got something on each day. Got 8 games and a manual. The first thing I got was a manual. It was a Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. This is a quarter. I saw it and I was like, you know what? I'm grabbing it. I know this game has a lot of value now. Well, not a lot, but it's like a $40 game or something. But I was like, you know what, a quarter for a freaking manual if I ever come across the game or something. And it doesn't have a manual. Then I got it. It's in decent shape. The next thing I got was yesterday. Ended up going out to the wineries yesterday on Saturday, so I didn't have much time to go to garage sales. But it was hot as hell the last freaking like 5 days. It is today, too. But I got these 3 PlayStation 2 games for a buck. Jack 2. This game's awesome. I played this back around the time it came out, I guess 2003. So they can always just open world. I know the first one is kind of open world, but not. This is like you're doing missions for people and stuff. It's a really cool game. I may go back and play this again. I'm not sure, though. But this is the only really game I was interested in. But, the lady was like, oh, what are there any other? Because I was like, oh, I think, how much are the games? And she's like, what? Board games? I was like, no, these video games. And she's like, oh, I don't know. Grab whatever you want for a buck. And there was only 3 there, PlayStation 2 games. So this is one of them. DDR Max Revolution. Dance Revolution. Another dance game now. Which I was like, fuck it, I'm going to grab it. Because it's 3 for a buck. I might as well, right? And The Incredibles, based on the movie. But that was still cool, you know. I mean, this is the game, only game I'm really interested in, obviously, but fuck it, I'll take the other two as well. And yesterday, I wasn't even plan on going to any, but there was one, there was a garage sale like around the block, literally like freaking 2 seconds around the block, and I was like, no, maybe I'll go there a little later in the day, and it's anything, you know, people put on the Craigslist, they put what they have. And I was like, you know, I'll check it out later, there's nothing, no thing of video games or anything like that. And then, like, at 10 o'clock, I just happen to go on Craigslist, and I go to the same one, and I see a picture with, like, Xbox 360 games, 2 apiece. I was like, are you kidding me? I fucking ran out the fucking door, you know, hopefully to get something, and I got very lucky, everything was still in there. I only used 10 bucks. I didn't want to spend any more. There was a couple other games I could have picked up, but probably smart not to. But the first one is Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary. It's the update, you know, the remake of the first Halo, and you can play it. I played this when it came out. Or maybe it was a little after it came out. Actually, it was, because I got it for pretty cheap back then. But it's the, you know, remade version of the first one, but you can play the old version as well. It's cool. You can like switch it back and forth at any time to the updated graphics or what it used to look like. But cool, it's classic Halo. It's still my favorite of all the Halo games. Spider-Man Edge of Time. Never played this. Sounds alright. Sounds interesting. It says here, 2099, a chaotic dystopian future results from the untimely death of Spider-Man. Fight across the span of a century to save the world and Spider-Man himself in this thrilling thrilling race against time. Sounds interesting. This one I grabbed, Far Cry 3, it's sealed. Still, I played this, and this game's awesome. I may throw it down again, or I may just keep it sealed, I don't know. A cool sealed copy is still cool to have for $2, and this one's cool, but I actually prefer the second one. I like the second one a lot. I need to get the second one again. I played it on PS3. I'd love to play it again, and I can get it for 360 and play through it again, because I this one's awesome, but I did enjoy the second one more. I played a little bit of the first, and I have not played the fourth or the primal. Fourth one here is Lego Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. These are all complete, except the Halo did not have its manual. But I grabbed this. I played this too back when it came out. This game is awesome. I'm a fan of the Lego games. They're just fun to play and shit. Fuck around. No big deal playing these games. They're not hard or anything. there's no like real consequences. When you get smashed into nothing, you just lose some coins or studs. But still a good one. I now have the complete saga, which has this in it, but I was grabbing it because it was $2. And the last one is the one I really wanted. This is a game I wanted to play for a while. I did not get it when it came out on the PS2. I did not have a PS2 at the time to play it. And then they put out the Scholarship Edition. This is Bully Scholarship Edition on the 360 and the Wii, I believe it came out on. But I saw it was in there. I was like, shit, man, I'm grabbing that immediately. This is the first one I grabbed. And it's got, I guess, enhanced graphics. I don't know how much better it looks. I know this is like a 2006 game for the Xbox. I don't know. It might have came out in 2005 or 4 or something for the PS2. I can't remember. But it's got 8 new missions, 4 new classes, 4 new characters, 2-player minigames. Obviously, it's got achievements. But it's a game I really wanted to play. I never got around to it. And this one has a little bit of value, so I never really wanted to pay, like, you know, even like 3-4 years ago, I didn't want to pay like $20-$25, you know, for this game. Especially if I got it from GameStop or something. Because this has got everything. It's got the map and the manual in there. And that would not have happened if I got it from GameStop. And eBay, yes, it probably would have, but like I said, it's like a $20-$25 game still. But I always wanted to play this. I can't wait to actually start playing this game. Hopefully my piece of shit Xbox 360 can still read the discs. That thing's a disaster. Still works though, so I can't complain. I ripped the top off. I don't know if I ever showed that on a video. I had to like rip the thing off, and now it actually runs better because I had to like fuck with the thing on the disc drive, the little screw, to get it to read discs again, and that worked because I bought it off my friend's brother in 2010. Got a great deal, $60, and I gave him some. Because he was upgrading to the, at the time, the other model 360 they put out, the one they should have originally put out, but didn't. But the better, you know, the better version they always put out years after the first one comes out. But I picked that, you know, I got that for a good price, but he even said, this don't work, you gotta like fuck with it to get it to work. And I was doing that for a little bit, and I was like, you know what, I'm cracking this open, trying to fix it, and I was actually able to. But I ripped that completely, ripped it apart, and the top is completely off of it, and it still works though, so can't complain. At some point I may just pick up a 360 system, because I still have a hard drive for it, because it has it's the one with a detachable hard drive. I got a lot of good stuff on there, so I may just pick up another one at some point for cheap if I see one at a garage sale or something, because then I have the power brick, I have the, you know, other cables and stuff. So yeah, just wanted to show that real quick, and I may put up a gameplay of this, because I really want to check this out. If anybody's played it, let me know how it is, because it always looked interesting to me. And I'm finally getting around to play it 10 years later. Well, 10 years for this version, 10 years later. I can't believe this is 10 years old already. I don't know why it boggles my mind that the 360 came out in 05. It's just because it lasted so long, that the PS3's lifespan was so long that it just seems like, you know, like it wasn't that long, but it was. And I'm still playing games for it, honestly. I still don't have an Xbox One or PS4. And honestly, I'm always like, I'm going to get one, and then I get the itch, and then I don't have the itch anymore. And you know what? I don't even know when I will get one. I may get one 2 years from now. I don't know. Maybe 6 months from now. It could be, you know, this fall. But I don't care. It's like, you know, I can grab this. I'm such a different gamer now. It's weird. Like, normally I would be like, I need the system. I've always been like that. I never waited longer than like 6 or 7 months to get a system after it came out. And now I'm just like, no. You know, I can wait. And all of a sudden, you know what? If I get the system's going to be cheaper. Either one of them, PS4, Xbox One. And the games are, a lot of the games I want are already cheap. So they'll even be cheaper then. So that's cool. But anyway, I'm rambling here. Those are the pickups I got. Very happy with them. And thanks everyone for checking it out. And have a good day.